Okay, so my last Harry Potter tutorial, I had a really bad stand, so I was off camera a lot. So I'm going to remake it. I've been meaning to, but I just got married, so it's been hectic. So we're gonna be doing this step on a wine tumbler, and then I will stop, and I will use my fast set epoxy. So then I'll come back and do the second step, which is the disappearing footprints. All right, so what you'll need is your sanded and primed cup, matte white, flat white. Then you'll need, you can tell these are used. I use all Tim Holtz. This one is honeycomb, and this one's sunshine yellow. And then this is teak wood. And then I just use makeup brushes or sponges. I also have new ones just in case I need them. And then I wear my gloves and I have my table covered because I don't want to stain my table. So let's get started. So I start with the tops and bottoms first. This is my brown, this is my yellow. So I put some on my sponge. And then I will start down here and I dab. Since this cup is a little smaller than the 20 ounce, it's not much. This is a 15 ounce wine. It does come with a lid as well, so I won't go down as far as I normally do just because I want to have enough room for my yellows. And you just dab it. So there's that. Okay, so now we're gonna do the bottom. I'm tabbing harder to get into this little crease that's on the bottom. It's not usually on any of the other tumblers, but this wine glass does have it. So then add a little more. Alcohol inks do dry fast, so just be aware of that. And to build up your color, you're gonna need to seal them. Usually I can get it dark enough with one layer and then blending that I don't need to seal them, but there's always a case that I do need to seal them. This is why I wear gloves. Put my lid on my alcohol ink so I don't dry it out. And now I'm going to start with my light yellow, which is my sunshine yellow from Tim Holtz. Put some on my sponge. And then I start all over at the bottom. Start at the bottom because I want to start blending it into the brown. And then I move my way up. You want to keep dabbing so you get that smoky look. If you just lay it on there, it's not going to look smoky. to the bottom. Don't worry about that line down there. We're gonna go back in with the brown. So then open. The honeycomb. And you can see on this side of the sponge is where I put the light. You can tell it's wet. So I'm gonna put it on the opposite side and start dabbing. See how it's darker. And this will get darker as it sits a little bit. It will set a little darker than when you stop putting it on. Okay, we're gonna go back over these spots that were a little more wet than the rest of the areas. This is where you started. Okay. Go back to our brown to blend in. So put a little bit on here. And then where that line is on the bottom, we're gonna go in and blend it out. And this is why I didn't go up as far, because when you're blending it in, you're still bringing up that brown. So you don't want to start too high up already. And then go up too far into the cup. Okay. And then we'll do a little bit at the top, but the top didn't seem to wash out too much. So we'll blend this. There we go. And there's a little spot I have and I don't really like too much. So let me do this. Okay. Okay. Alright, so that's step number one. I'm gonna let this dry. I'm gonna spray it, have it set, and then we will do a coat of fast set, and I'll come back in a couple hours and do step two.